So I decided to sleep on it and see what happened. And at about 6:30 in the morning, I hear a vehicle coming. And I see flashing lights. And I'm thinking, oh God, here comes the cops or something. I don't know what it was. It drove past me. I assume they didn't even hear me or didn't even see me. I don't know how they could, and I was 5 feet off the side of the road. Probably someone who's drove that road a million times and just totally didn't see me. You know, if you think about it, if you drive the same route every day, like to work, there's shit that will change that you don't notice, and then there's shit that will change you do notice. So my guess is the guy's looking to the right, I was on the left, or maybe he just saw me and didn't care. But finally, about, so I have my alarm set for 6:45 every morning, so I can get up, try to get breakfast in me and coffee, and out by 7 or 7:15. But I was still in that, should I call it, mood. So I laid in the hammock till about 7:30. Then I got up, because I don't have any water for coffee or breakfast. I knew the next place didn't have water. It was like a mile away or 8/10 of a mile away. God only knows where I was going to find water at. But I decided that I was going to push on. Can't give up. And I don't know where it was at. I finally got water. The good thing was it was cool. It much cooler night. I was in my had my underquilt and top quilt. The top quilt's rated at 40 degrees. The underquilt is 40 degrees plus 2 ounces of overstuff, so I don't know, 30 degrees maybe on it. I got woke up 2 or 3 times in the middle of the night, cold. That morning was cold when I finally did get out of the hammock. So the first hour or two of my hike was mostly to stay warm once I did finally get going. But I finally found water and I wasn't sweating much, so that was good. And then I looked at the trail notes, and it was basically saying that there was going to be good water sources like every 15 feet for the next 20 miles, which really meant there would be a good water source once every 6 miles if you didn't pass it by without seeing it. So I took my chances, and when I found a water source, I put 1 liter in the bladder, 1 liter in my smart water bottle in case that I decided to have breakfast, which I never did, and carried on. Amazingly, I made it to the intersection of where the Sheltowee Trace Spur Trail now goes to Pickett State Park. I've done this a couple of times. This is known as foot maintenance. Your feet is like your car, And foot maintenance is like changing the oil in your car. So you basically use your body to smack out as much dust out of your 5-day-old socks that you can in any kind of sticks or briars or anything else. Oh, but we aren't done, because we have to turn the sock inside out and do the at that side too. The briars are the ones that you really have to watch for, because they don't show up very good, but they get embedded in your sock and you feel them when you're walking with a rubbing feeling. They do things like this. Scratches on the legs from same said briars. But if they get in your sock, they do this. And of course, 5-day-old unwashed feet. And not to be too sickening to you, but that also means 5-day-old toe jam. You get to clean out with your fingers. Not really. I try to do this every day or two, so. Still, 2 days of toe jam. Pretty fucking nasty. Sure I'm going to have to edit that out. Feet maintenance, very important for hiking. Long distance hiking. If you're just doing a weekend hike or a week long hike or car camping, not a big deal. But if you're doing long distance hiking, it's pretty urgent that you take care of your feet. I've twisted this ankle twice. And it's been a little sore today. So along with feet care goes shoe care. You're basically emptying out any crap that's in there. And then once you get the loose stuff out, stick your hands down in there and rub them around to get the stuff loosened up that's already dried and turned into a chalk. Probably heard it. I heard it. My Brooks Cascadia. I really like these shoes. I think these are 10s. Brooks Cascadia 10, I think. I've got Dr. Soles Active Series insoles installed. I've always had really good luck with. But I think the Dr. Soles insoles went out. Uh, 20 miles or so into this hike. They've been bothering my feet quite a bit. Or the trail's been bothering my feet quite a bit, which is really unusual because I hike a lot. I don't know why the right leg does not look near as bad as the left leg. I think a bear tried to get me and I just didn't notice it. Maybe that's what it is. The muscles in my legs are extremely sore. So that's a foot maintenance.
Either a deer or a bear right up there. A deer. I don't think a bear would come around me speaking like this.
So that's the other thing. Today I saw, let me go ahead and tell you about this. So I've seen bear scat throughout Tennessee, and now I'm in Kentucky, 8 or 9 miles from the border. And I've seen a lot of bear scat today, and I've seen a lot of bear markings on the trees where they mark, the males mark their height to set up their territories on the trees, and I've taken a couple pictures of that stuff. So I am definitely in bear territory. So in Tennessee, I didn't hardly see any bear sign, but about the time I got close to the Kentucky border, from there on, I've seen a lot of bear signs. I'm pretty certain that was a deer, though. It went, hey, deer. Hey, deer. Hey, deer. Hey, deer. Hey, deer. And there we have the answer. It's a deer, for sure. Hi, deer. Oh well, so that's how Day 4 is going. Day 4 was not very good. Day 5's been a little bit better. Slower on the trail miles. And I'm going to pack up and get out of here while animals are looking at me like I'm crazy. So, this is kind of related to Day 4. So the deer showing up. Probably was at a really good time. If you ever ask for a sign to keep going, that was my sign. Day 5, a little early. Let me show you this. Where I'm at now. I don't know if you can tell. Let's just walk. And let me show you what I'm faced with today on Day 5. I'm actually running next to a creek, so water, although I hear it, there's not many opportunities to get close to it. Steep banks. I did actually find one place I got water. But planning this hike in the fall, on Day 5, actually Day 4, maybe Day 3, I started to realize it, but today especially, Day 5. Planning this hike in the fall was maybe not the greatest idea. It hasn't rained in forever, so that explains the water sources being low. The leaves are falling, which camouflages the ground. And if I wasn't an experienced hiker and also an experienced hunter and trapper, I probably would not be able to find this trail a lot of times. I mean, can you tell where the trail is? If you look down, it looks like just the rest of the ground. There are some places that I have to just stop and look around and hope and pray I can find a trail marker, which are few and far between, as I've mentioned before. And just like where is the trail? So that's it for now. massive waterfall is barely putting out any water. You can see the little bit there-ish. This is where, unfortunately, it has to end. I rolled an ankle, and right away, my ITB said, we're done. Right now, I just came from this direction. And so, GPS trail miles for today is 1320. The last mile or two really took me a long time. Let's see if I can recall this off of memory. It was after the large waterfall, and then there's another part where you're going past some like boulders and overhangs and things, and I had like a few steps going down. You can actually kind of see where mud on my leg from the fall.